Hi students, let us learn how to solve boats and streams problem and students row problem with the help of algebraic equations. Students, let us learn some formulas relating to boats and streams. Let x kilometer per hour be the speed of the boat in still water and y kilometer per hour be the speed of the stream. Also let u kilometer per hour be the speed of the boat downstream. And v kilometer per hour be the speed of the boat upstream. Then speed of the boat downstream u equal to x plus y kilometer per hour. Again v equal to x minus y, that is speed of the boat minus speed of the stream. We have also learned x equal to u plus v by 2 and y equal to u minus v by 2. Students, all these four formulas are very important to solve the boats and streams problem. Students, let us solve the problem. Madhu can row downstream 30 km in 3 hours and 30 km upstream in 5 hours. Find the speed of rowing in still water and the speed of stream. Students, Madhu can row 30 km in 3 hours. Therefore, the speed of rowing downstream equal to distance by time, that is 30 by 3 equal to 10 kilometer per hour. Hence, suppose it is u equal to 10 km per hour. Again, we see in 5 hours, Madhu can row 30 km in upstream. Therefore, the speed of rowing upstream equal to v equal to distance by time, that is 30 km by 5 km per hour, that is 6 km per hour. Hence, the speed of rowing in still water equal to u plus v by 2 kilometer per hour, that is 10 plus 6 by 2 kilometer per hour, that is 8 kilometer per hour. And speed of the stream equal to u minus v by 2, that is 10 minus 6 by 2 equal to 4 by 2, that is 2 kilometer per hour. Therefore, the speed of rowing in still water equal to 8 kilometer per hour and the speed of the stream equal to 2 kilometer per hour. Let us consider the second problem. A boat goes 60 kilometer downstream and 40 kilometer upstream in 16 hours. In 9 hours, it can go 40 kilometer downstream and 20 kilometer upstream. Find the speed of the boat in still water and that of the stream. Students, let u equal to speed of the boat downstream and v equal to speed of the boat upstream. Hence, as per first condition, sixty by u plus 40 by v equal to 16. Suppose it is equation number 1. Students, the boat goes 60 kilometer downstream at the speed of u kilometer per hour. Therefore, time taken to go 60 kilometer is 60 by u, and time taken to go 40 kilometer upstream at the speed of v kilometer per hour equal to 40 by v, and total time taken equal to 16 hours. Therefore, 60 by u plus 40 by v equal to 16. Students, in second condition, in 9 hours it can go 40 kilometer downstream. Therefore, 40 by u plus 20 kilometer upstream, that is 20 by v equal to 9 hours. Suppose it is equation number 2. Now let us multiply the equation number 2 by 2. So it will be 80 by u plus 40 by v equal to 18. Let us write the first equation, that is 60 by u plus 40 by v equal to 16. Let us subtract 20 by u equal to 2. This implies that u equal to 10. Therefore, from 1 we get 60 by 10 plus 40 by v equal to 16. This implies that 40 by v equal to 16 minus 6, that is 10. This implies that v equal to 40 by 10 equal to 4. Therefore, the speed of the boat in still water equal to u plus v by 2, 10 plus 4 by 2, that is 7 kilometer per hour, and the speed of the stream equal to u minus v by 2, that is 10 minus 4 by 2 equal to 3 kilometer per hour. Students, in my earlier videos relating to speed, time and distance, you may get more problems relating to boats and streams. The link of the videos are attached in the description of this video. Students, let us consider the student's row problem. The students of a class are made to stand in rows. If three students are extra in a row, there could be one row less. If three students are less, then there could be two rows more. Find the number of students in the class. Let us consider x be the number of students in each row and let y be the number of rows students. Here see, students of a class are made to stand in rows. So the total students of the class equal to x into y. Here we consider x be the number of students in each row and y be the total number of rows. Therefore, total student of the class is x into y. As per first condition, if three students are extra, that is x plus 3, then there could be one row less. Therefore, the row will be y minus 1. This equals to x into y. This implies that xy minus x plus 3y minus 3 equal to xy. This implies that xy cancelled. Minus x plus 3y equal to 3. Suppose it is equation number 1. Now as per second condition, if three students are less in a row, that is in a row students will be x minus 3, then the number of rows will be 2 more, that is y plus 2 equal to xy. This implies that xy plus 2x minus 3y minus 6 equal to xy. This implies that xy cancelled. 2x minus 3y equal to 6. Suppose it is equation number 2. Students, let us multiply the equation number 1 by 2. Let us multiply equation number 1 by 2 and adding with 2, we get minus twice x plus 6y equal to 6. From 2 we can write twice x minus 3y equal to 6. So adding we get 3y equal to 12. This implies that y equal to 4. Now let us substitute the value of y in equation number 1. So from 1 we get minus x plus 3 into 4 equal to 3. This implies that x equal to 12 minus 3 equal to 9. Students, so we get Total number of students in each row is 9 and number of rows is equal to 4. Therefore, total number of students in the class equal to xy equal to 9 into 4, that is 36. Students, let us consider the fourth problem. Some amount is distributed among the villagers. If there are 50 villagers less, everyone will get rupees 120 more. If there are 60 villagers more, everyone will get rupees 100 less. Find the number of villagers and how much amount each get. Let x be the number of villagers and rupees y each get. Hence, total amount distributed equal to x into y. Now, as per first condition, if there are 50 villagers less, then the total villagers will be x minus 50. Then everyone will get rupees 120 more. So everyone will get y plus 120. This equal to total amount distributed, that is xy. This implies that xy plus 120x minus 50y minus 6000 equal to xy. This implies that xy cancelled. 120x minus 50y equal to 6000. This equals to 12x minus 5y equal to 600. Suppose it is equation number 1. Now from second condition, we get, then the total villagers will be x plus 60 and everyone will get rupees 100 less. So everyone will get y minus 100. This equals to x into y, that is total amount distributed. Xy minus 100x plus 60y minus 6000 equal to xy. Here xy cancelled. This implies that minus 100x plus 60y equal to 6000. Students, let us divide both the sides by 20. So this implies that minus 5x plus 3y equal to 300. Let us consider the, this is equation number 2. Students, now let us multiply the equation number 1 by 3. So we get, it is 36x minus 15y equal to 1800. And let us multiply the equation number 2 by 5. So we get minus 25x plus 15y equal to 1500. Now adding, we get 11x equal to 3300. This implies that x equal to 3300 by 11 equal to 300. Now let us substitute the value of x in equation number 1. So from 1 we get 12 into 300 minus 5y equal to 600. This implies that 3600 minus 600 equal to 5y. This implies that y equal to 3000 by 5 equal to 600. Hence, there are 300 villagers and everyone gets rupees 600. Students, in this video we learn how to solve boats and streams problem and also students row problem. Students, I think the problems are very easy to solve. I therefore advise you to follow the video from beginning to end to learn the process properly. Thank you for watching the video.